Does anyone else think it's weird that all these toothpastes have men's names like Tom, David, and Jason? Hi YouTube, welcome back to my channel, and if it's your first time here, we talk about everything that drives me in my weight loss journey, from plant-based diets to gluten-free diets to eating a more holistic lifestyle. So if you like the content you see, you should consider subscribing. So in today's video, I wanted to make a quick one. I've been vegan for a little over 7 months now, plant-based, and as I've said in some other videos, I'm trying to eat more holistically and not putting as many processed things in my body. So recently I went on a, not really a grocery haul, but like on a health haul. I don't really know how you would classify that, but I basically sought out toothpaste, obviously, and a few other hygiene types of products that are going to be more holistic and not as harmful to my body. So for instance, all the toothpastes you see right now in front of you are probably, some of them are household names, obviously, like Sensodyne, Colgate, Crest. I mean, there's nothing like wrong with them in the sense that if you use them, I'm not going to think, you know, that you're less of a person or something. It's just, you know, and obviously they keep your teeth clean and you go to the dentist and they seem fine with it too. But I just wanted to start using products that didn't contain a lot of dyes and that were vegan friendly. So the interesting thing to note is this toothpaste in particular, the Colgate Optic White Renewal, is somewhat newer, I believe, to the market. They have the whitening one and they have a few others. They're actually vegan. So let me see if I can. So yeah, they're actually vegan and gluten-free. So that's kind of pretty cool that a toothpaste finally came out and put that on, you know, their toothpaste. But still wasn't okay for me to use because this toothpaste puts a dye in the toothpaste and it also puts another chemical in there that I just was looking on Google and a few other places and I just really wanted to stay away from it. PVP and PEG PPG 116/66 copolymer. Yeah, so that's in most of the toothpastes. So it's like right in here somewhere. So anywho, most of the toothpastes have dyes or chemicals like that in the toothpaste. But the reason I went with all these brands over here, like Tom's, Hello, Jason, David, and Dr. Bronner's. Does anyone else think it's weird that all these toothpastes have men's names like Tom, David, and Jason? Like, they couldn't put, like, a Jennifer or, like, a Teresa or a Diana on any of the boxes? Anywho, maybe we need to make our own toothpaste. But all these toothpastes actually are vegan, and they are no animal testing. So Tom's, for instance, if you can see, it shows no animal testing. It's also has no artificial colors, flavors, fragrances, or preservatives. So, I mean, I think that's pretty awesome. I know the dentist office definitely carries this, especially for children. They make a Tom's one for children. The Hello brand came in either activated charcoal with fluoride or without. I got the one with fluoride because I was reading on their website they want to give their customers the option to choose, and unless your water has fluoride already in it, then it's really not that big of a deal. I guess it's for people that are concerned about getting too much like fluoride. It's Leaping Bunny certified, which means it's never tested on animals, and it's vegan, which is pretty awesome. They also contain no peroxides, no artificial sweeteners, no artificial flavors, no dyes, no preservatives, no SLS sulfites, no parabens, and it's pretty much a no-brainer. So that's all listed right here, which I love. Then we got the Jason brand. So I got peppermint. They had a spearmint one as well. But I didn't want to go with that because I'm really not a spearmint person. So I went with the peppermint. And it's a whitening toothpaste as well. This one has no sodium lauryl sulfates, no preservatives, no artificial colors, no artificial sweeteners, no saccharine, no propylene glycol, and no gluten. So this one is as well, it has the bunny on it, so you know it's vegan. Pretty excited about this one as well. I have not tried any of these toothpastes yet, but I plan to in the next video. So I wanted to kind of just explain why I'm switching. And then in the next video I do on toothpaste, which won't be the very next video, but in a few weeks or a month or so after I've used pretty much all of these, I'm going to kind of give my final review on which ones were my favorite. I mean, I know we're not eating toothpaste, but the taste still has to be somewhat tolerable. You can't just have something that you're brushing your teeth with and it's the most disgusting thing, you know, that you put on your toothbrush. So I'll give my full review in a little bit of time, so we'll just put it that way. David's is the same, so it's a charcoal peppermint, fluoride free this one is, and then on the back it definitely says it's naturally sourced and naturally derived ingredients, fluoride free, no sodium lauryl sulfates, sulfate free, vegan, plant and earth based, no artificial flavors, sweeteners, colors, or preservatives, no animal testing, it's made in America, and has sustainable packaging, it's recyclable metal tube, and it's family owned and operated. Pretty awesome right here. So I'm pretty impressed, David. Thank you. So we'll definitely try this one out. And then the last one is pretty common. You can find it in most places. It's Dr. Bronner's. It's a all-in-one toothpaste. I got the peppermint again. I like a peppermint toothpaste. This one specifically has 70% organic ingredients, so I don't know what the other 30% are. Flavored with pure organic essential oils, no artificial flavors or sweeteners, fluoride-free and SLS-free, no synthetic detergents or foaming agents, no artificial preservatives or colors. It has organic aloe, which helps soothe the gums, and it's certified vegan and cruelty-free. It's fair trade as well, and organic coconut oil that supports community development. That's awesome as well. So pretty excited to try all these toothpastes. Just get these out of the way. So pretty excited to try all these toothpastes and give my final review. Like I said, it'll be maybe in a few weeks or a month or so, because I want to give them all a fair chance. Obviously, if you brush 2 to 3 times a day, I'll try to alternate and rotate them and give my fair opinion on them and recommend which ones I think you guys should buy. But yeah, so I just wanted to make the conscious effort myself to switch out my toothpaste, to be investing in and paying for a product that doesn't test on animals, that is certified vegan, gluten-free, that doesn't have chemicals. Even though, you know, I'm only brushing my teeth with them, it still goes into your gums and it gets absorbed into your digestive system and your bloodline. And it's just not something that I would like to be putting in my body anymore. So for me personally, this is the switch I'm making. Again, like I said, if you still use Colgate, Crest, Sensodyne, any of the other commercially marketed toothpastes, I mean, that's great. I'm sure your teeth are fine. You have no cavities. But for me, I really want to have not only a great smile, but to know that I'm doing something that's sustainably correct and, you know, helping the environment and also protecting my body and my teeth. So appreciate you watching. You know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe, share the video if you liked it. And as always, guys, stay driven.